Happy Sunday, everybody. I hope you are having a sweet, sweet Sunday. I've made a couple new journals to go in the shop, and I wanted to show those to you today. I had an off week last week, and I think it's okay to talk about things like this, especially when they're over. I practice law of attraction, and basically law of attraction is ask and it is given, seek and you'll find, knock and it will be open to you. You kind of manifest what you think about. So you try and keep your thoughts really clean and really good, and you know, because we live in a vibrational universe, if you're vibrating on a high frequency, or you're vibrating on a positive frequency, then your life is just generally kind of going to go a little bit better. I had a wobble, what we call a wobble in law of attraction universe, and I can't even explain it. My wobble happened on Tuesday, and that was January the 17th, and, you know, January the 17th, is that the 17th? It happened on Tuesday, that was the 16th. The 17th, we had a new moon, which is, you know, generally just a great time for creative people. But my wobble happened on Tuesday the 16th, and I can't even explain it. I don't really even know what happened. But the thing is that when I hit that wobble, I know what to do. I stop creating. I do anything except sit here and make journals, because I think that when you're a creative person, your art absorbs the energy that is kind of in your body or in your aura or whatever. I hope I'm not getting too woo-hoo out there for you, but I really do believe that, and I think that creativity taps into your inner being, and when your lines of communication between you and your source, it gets kind of muddy, then it's time to stop. It's time to tell yourself a new story. It's time to lay new pipes. It's just a process. So you don't get in the hole, right? So you're doing whatever you can to just stay away from the edge of dropping into the hole. And I think that we all know what that is about. So what happened was I stopped creating journals, and I clean house. I organize things. I organize things in the house. I throw things away. I organize things in the studio. I was out of those jumbo paper clips, so I toyed with a new idea for paper clips to use in the journals, and that turned out so well. And I thought, well, see, I mean, being on a wobble is helping me kind of channel that wobble into something creative, and I felt really good about that. I started an ephemera project. I have tons of ephemera from Billboard magazine and Variety magazine from 1966, and I've had those items in like vinegar and coffee grounds for quite some time now. So I started processing that ephemera and felt really good about that. I planned and caught up on my Moonstruck work, which is my company, and mostly I made lists of positive aspects. I made lists of what I was thankful for, what I was appreciating right at that moment. A hot cup of coffee. The house was warm. The day was sunny. It was going to be 60 degrees, you know. So I was just listing positive aspects. And then, really, by Friday, I was just feeling a whole lot better. I was feeling more in alignment. You know, different schools of thought. That's a different word in different schools of thought. You know, enlightenment, or feeling your God source, or feeling in tune, or tapped in, or whatever you want to call it. Anyway, so Friday night, and this is where the journals start. Friday night, I had a dream, and I had a dream about the colors blue and the color green. I also had a dream specifically about this pattern, this fabric pattern that my art angel had sent me that I had not used yet. So I woke up Saturday morning and I was tuned in, tapped in, turned on. I was ready to work. And I came up with these journals. These journals are, they're kind of like self-healing journals. They're very whimsical. They kind of take you back to childhood. You know, it's never too late to have a happy childhood. So maybe this is, you know, this is kind of where you can start. The colors in my dream were just exceptional. I was dreaming of blue. I was dreaming of green. I don't know if you know a lot about dream analogy, but blue is a cool analytical color, and it represents, you know, like intellectual and spiritual insights and faith and relaxation and that kind of thing. Of course, green we associate with nature and growth and vitality and contentment and things like that. So anyway, that's what happened with these journals. They are literally journals that I dreamed, and I think it's okay to tell you guys that, and hopefully you don't think I'm woohoo out there way too much. But the journals turned out so fun, and I went to show them to you. This one has fairy houses on it, and I say fairy houses because the doors are oval. This one is square. This one's round. A couple of them are oval. I just thought it was just the sweetest fabric, and honestly, it just made me happy, and that's why I chose it for this journal. I finished it off with some paper beads, and these are handmade paper beads that I have a huge stash of paper beads because it was kind of my addiction for a little while. I'm sure that I'll go back to that addiction, but golly, I've got a whole lot, and they make me happy just looking at them. I finished this off with a brad that just says zero on it, or an O, like, oh, this journal makes me happy, or oh, these houses are fun and cool. These journals are definitely whimsical. They may even be appropriate for a child. Like I said, it's a self-help, self-comfort, self-healing sort of journal that is very lighthearted and very fun. You can see that I started using these bobby pin paper clips, bobby pins as paper clips, and put flowers on them along with, you know, our hairy fabric elements that we've been using. This is a great opportunity to write a new story for yourself. And you can do it. You do not have to live that story that you've lived for so long. This is a bright, happy, fun book for you to write your new story in. Lay some new pipes, as they say in Abraham land. You know, when your pipes get muddy and icky and nothing can move through them, then it's time to lay some new pipes. And even if you just do that metaphorically, I mean, don't go in your yard and start digging things up, unless you feel compelled to do that. But it's a very, very nice way to think new thoughts and think better thoughts. And no matter what, guys, you can do it. You can think better thoughts, and those thoughts help you manifest better things in your life. I used a few pages from a fairy book. This was just a child's fairy craft book. This one is drawing in a fairy mirror. Words begin with F that you're going to draw in the mirror here. Some really sweet papers for you to play with. Origami paper. These are Valentine's Day cards. I love Curious George. So I put a couple of those in there for you. There are more in the back of this book. Places to write, places to dream, a few fairy stickers because that just makes you happy. A card that says you are rad. I realize we don't say rad very much anymore. My kids said it. It was like skateboard terminology, rad dude, when they were little. I've got lots of fun papers for you to play with, a lot of new papers for you to play with. This is an owl, a card that says, I heart you. Some sparkle that says thank you. Of course, the pockets are packed with papers for you to play around with. More from the little fairy book. I just love that fairy book. It just makes me happy. Clifford the big red dog. Rod a unicorn. Swim with mermaids. Chase a rainbow. That's going to be my motto for 2018. This is a hidden pocket and has a plastic bag full of elements for you to play with. Some hearts because it's Valentine's. You could take this book, you guys, and part it out and make a lot of really super cool Valentine cards with it. I love the papers are just sweet and luscious in here. And this is another example of the new kind of clips that I'm using. This is a clothespin, and I just put a rolled paper flower on it. And if you guys are interested in these flowers, I can do a tutorial about them. I think I did a tutorial a long time ago. These are vintage text page dyed paper rolled roses. God, that was hard to say. But they are fun to do. They're just a little, you kind of get addicted to them, and then your hands start hurting. But they're still a lot of fun. Make your own fairy puppet. We have some, I think that's a Yahtzee scorecard, a little birthday tag. Of course, with the tags, you can always flip it over and work on the back where you've got a blank canvas to play with right there. And more small tags, a butterfly, a skinny book. More stickers. A little thing that I did last year that says blessed. And more papers, ATCs, a nice little flashcard for you to play. I'm running low on flashcards. I think I'm going to have to try and find some. I do love the vintage flashcards. This is one of the vintage Christmas cards. I love the angel popping out of the mailbox. Something to color. This card is signed by Jackie Corneo. I love just thinking about, and that's from that ephemera stack that's been dating 41 to 55 or so. That one was not dated, but I'm thinking that it's probably about that time period. More papers for you to play with. Remember, there's just tons and tons of fiber here. Lots of fun fiber. Bookmarks for you to complete. This one says Free Spirit. A little doggy because he's just so cute. And another of the, I'm using the binder clips to also do the hairy paperclip thing now, which I'm really liking. That worked out perfectly. I ran out of paper clips. I was not feeling like going out and getting jumbo paper clips. So even that wobble that I experienced, that law of attraction wobble that I experienced, helped me define a new way to make these books better. It helped me define a new way to, if I ran out of jumbo paper clips, to use something else. It expanded my brain, is what it did. This is a great photo. This is a vintage postcard, and it says reunion with three generations in Baghdad, 2004. And I just thought that was super cool. This is a vintage postcard from my friend Anne, who is a writer, and she just has all kinds of beautiful vintage things that she sends my way because she knows that I will love them and I will use them. So there we go, guys. Let's just call her Fairy Huts, and this is a $35 journal, and she'll be going in the shop this afternoon. This is the fabric that I had the dream about. It was very vivid. When I woke up Saturday morning, I made a pot of coffee and I immediately, I like skipped my whole morning routine. I did not read my meditation book. I did not make a list of positive aspects. I didn't do anything but jump right into this fabric and get this little book in the go. She is finished with more paper beads. I so enjoy making paper beads. And the brad here is a flower. I do have a little rose that's stuck to the front of here, but you know, you can move that if you want to. And we start out with a paper clip. I love these paper clips. I mean, I love these clothespins. Aren't they so pretty? And this fabric kind of reminded me of a Moroccan thing going on. You know how much I like that. Encouraging you to write your story. Write yourself a new story. This is Design a Fairy Castle. I have lots of papers for you to play with. I love this post, this Christmas card. And let's see if we can find... This is Ruth Allen who sent this Christmas card. I think I like it because it's kind of not traditional Christmas, is it? I mean, it's just such a sweet little card. More of the envelopes to go with the Valentine cards. And this, it has Clifford the Big Red Dog, some origami paper. Places for you to write or draw, expand, dream, do whatever you want. A little fairy sticker and a card here. I thought that butterfly was so pretty. It's so simple. It's like yellow, but it has like these orangish dots on it. It's very neat. Some ATC cards for you to play with. Some skinny books right here. You Are My Favorite. I loved all of these sentiments. Live It Up, Hello Dear, Miss You Already, The Best. And more papers for you to play with. I love this paper. It's got a little owl on it. And it's, no, it's got some sort of coating on it that just kind of makes it shiny and fun to look at. You Are Fabulous, of course you are. A little bookmark that says Be Free. I loved this. My friend Jeannie sent me some napkins, and I am crazy in love with this little hula girl. And I knew that you guys can make something so spectacular with her. She was just adorable. She is a free spirit. Some puffy stickers, glitter paper, border strips, more paper for you to play with. This is some vintage, I think this is second grade education ephemera. You know, you could take this out and complete it and give yourself a triple A plus. You know, maybe that's your new story. Maybe you did not have such a positive education experience. And your new story can be completing your worksheet, getting a smiley face, and getting a triple A plus on it. Write your new story, y'all. Write it. You can do it. This is some packaging and things for you to play with. More papers, more skinny books, a list of vocabulary words. Who among us has not wanted to run away? And that's kind of our little bunny lady looks like, I'm going to get away from all this. And if you want to run away, then where are you going to run away to? What are you going to do? You know, where are you going to travel to? Running away is not, you can do it metaphorically, you can do it physically, and it doesn't have to even be far. You know, you can run away to your own backyard in the right attitude and just have yourself a little vacation in your backyard. Unless it's cold and muddy like it is in my house. More papers to play with. This is Design Your Own Hot Air Balloon. I love precious moments, so I put a little precious moments kiddo in here. These are some fabric bookmarks for you to play with. More of the rolled paper roses made from vintage text pages. A pocket just stuffed with skinny books, border strips, papers, ATCs, more papers. And our motto for 2018, ride a unicorn, swim with mermaids, chase a rainbow. Yes. We're going to do all that. This is a pocket of stuff for you to play with. And more papers back here. I kind of love these papers. This was kind of like a thick, and this was a medium, and this was a super thin right here. Got a felt owl for you. I love him. Fairy stickers. And this is a sweet front of a card that says thinking of you. And it has a hummingbird and flowers on it. So what shall we call this one? Let's call this one Blue Dream. I think that would be a nice name for it. This is a $35 journal. Both of these are going in the shop today, you guys. Thanks so much. Oh my gosh. We got way off frame there. Oh gosh. I hope that we're okay. I will go back and review this and make sure that you can see what's going on. Oh my goodness. Sometimes my camera just moves, y'all. It's crazy. Okay, guys, have a wonderful day, and I will talk to you soon. Thank you. Bye.